Hey kids, today we are going to learn how to collaborate on a Google Slide. Now this is a sample presentation that I had created using Google Slide. Now suppose I want to share this presentation with others. Suppose I am working in a breakout room and I want to create a presentation and I want my team members to work on that presentation along with me. So how to do it? So you create a presentation like this, and on the top right corner you have this share option in yellow color. So when you click on this share option, share with people and groups dialog box opens in front of you. So you can ask your team members to write their email IDs in the chat box, and you can copy and paste those email IDs over here. So suppose if I want to add a team member for me, so say then I'll write their email ID over here. Suppose I'm getting a prompt like this, then I can directly select the email ID from here. If I'm not getting, then I'll have to type in the email ID. You can also copy paste the email ID. So when you enter the email ID, a new box appears. See over here, you can also write a message or a note for that person whom you are adding as a collaborator for your Google Slide. So you can add like, please collaborate with, also write a note that which slide you want them to change, or which slide you want them to look at. Whatever message you want to give them, you can write over here and click on send, this send option. Now there is one more thing that you need to remember. When you share something, there is a one more option that comes in front of you, that is editor. See, this is the permission that you are giving that particular collaborator for your Google Slide. So there are three types of permission. First one is viewer, commenter and editor. So you can set the permission the way you want it. Suppose you want them to make the changes in your Google Slide, then you can make them editor. You want them to only view the Google Slide, then you can make them viewer. You want them to comment on your Google Slide, suggest you the changes they want in your Google Slide, then you can make them commenter. Now in the share with people and groups dialog box, at the bottom you see one more option, get link. So when we click over here, this icon, the get link icon over here, it gives you a link to share. Now below that it is written restricted. Now restricted means only people added can open with this link. So you have to add people, then only you can, that those people can open this Google Slide with the link given. Now suppose you want to, suppose you don't know the email ID of all the people. Okay, so suppose you don't know the email ID of all the people of your team or all your team members, then you can click on this and see the Acres Foundation thing is here. So all the email IDs that are from Acres Foundation or from our school, so will get access to this PPT. Now if we select Acres Foundation, so it means that anyone in this school or group with this link can view. Now see over here, you can use this option to share the presentation in a breakout room or when you are working in a group to quickly share a presentation. You don't need to take everybody's email ID and add them. If you don't have that much time, you can directly click on get link icon, click to change restricted to Acres Foundation, and the permission should also be updated. See over here, the viewer permission should be updated. You want them to be viewer, then keep it viewer. If you want them to be commenter, keep it commenter. If you want them to edit the presentation, you can keep them editor. Now you just need to click on this copy link and the link gets copied, and just paste this link in the chat box so that everybody in your group can open the presentation and start working on it. And you just need to click on done after this. Now suppose sometimes you have added certain people as an editor, and after some time you don't want them to be editor of your presentation. Then what to do at that time? If you want to change the permission access, so you click on share once again, and you will see a list of all the people who are there as your collaborator or editor. Yeah, so you just need to, in front of the name, it will be written either editor or viewer or commenter. So you just need to click on this editor, and you can remove these people. See, you can remove them, you can make them owner so that they can also change the permission. They can also add different people. If you remove them, then only you will have the access to edit the presentation. Once you remove somebody, you have to, or once you change the permission, you have to click on save to make it happen. I hope this was useful.